Hi, hello my dear students. Welcome to my video lecture class. Right up to now, I uploaded video lectures on the chapter Magnetic Effect of Current. Dear student, in this chapter, how to find the magnitude of magnetic field, how to find the direction of magnetic field. Based upon these two questions, the magnitude of magnetic field can be found by using Biot-Savart's law. Direction of magnetic field can be finding by using some rules. So these are all we discussed in previous lectures. So please watch that previous lectures for better understanding. So now in this session, I am going to discuss few more details and a few more applications of Biot-Savart's law I will discuss. So now, first one, in application one, two cases already I discussed, case one and case two. Now I am going to discuss case three. In application one, two cases already I discussed. So how the magnetic field is acting on a point due to finite length of wire, how the magnetic field is acting due to infinite length of wire. These two cases I already discussed in previous lectures. Now Case 3, semi-infinite length of wire, that means, semi means one end is fixed end. For finite length of wire, ends are fixed. So please observe carefully. For finite length of wire, ends are fixed because some particular length. Finite means particular length. So that's why ends are fixed. For infinite length of wire, ends are free. So semi-infinite means one end is free and another end is fixed end. Okay, one end is a fixed end, another end is free end. So here is the point, some point P. Now, so what are the steps? Step one is draw a imaginary line from the point to fixed end. You know already steps. First step is draw a imaginary line from point, that fixed end to point, and here this is a free end. We can't able to draw this. For a free end, it will forms definitely angle 90 degrees. This is a perpendicular distance. This is step 2. What is step 1? Draw a imaginary line from fixed end to point. This is fixed end and this is a point. Imaginary line we drawn. And this is a free end. We can't able to draw a line from free end to point P. So that's why this is a perpendicular line we should consider. You know already, node point, already in the previous lectures I discussed. What is the node point? For free end, pi is equal to 90 degrees. For fixed end, angle pi is less than 90 degrees. So these two are important. Okay? Pi is equal to 90 degrees for the fixed end. And pi is equal to less than 90 degrees for free end. This is a fixed end. That's why this is less than 90 degrees. And angle is, we consider this is a pi 1. And here it is an angle 90 degrees. This is a pi 2. And how to draw this? This is a pi 2 90 degrees. Okay. So now, what is magnetic field at this point P? Some I be the current passing through this wire. Let us consider semi-infinity. Semi-infinite means one end is infinite length of wire, one end is, it is not ended. Infinite means it is not ended. That's why it is a free end. One end is free end, another end is fixed end means that is semi-infinite length of wire. I be the current passing through this wire. If any conductor, some current is passing through it, definitely it will produce some magnetic field. That magnetic field is acting on point P. That we need to find. How to find magnetic field at this point P? Already you know, mu naught I by 4 pi d into sin pi 1 plus sin pi 2. Sin pi 1 plus sin pi 2. And here, mu naught I by 4 pi d into sin pi 1 only. And pi 2 is 90 degrees, sin 90 degrees. Sin 90 degrees, okay? So, you don't know, we don't know that pi 1 is equal to some pi I consider. Pi 2 is equal to 90 degrees I consider. Substitute those values, pi 1 value is pi. So, finally what we got here? Mu naught I by 4 pi d into 1 plus sin pi. So, sin 90 value 1, that's why 1 plus sin pi. This is magnetic field at point P. So, magnetic field at point P due to semi-infinite length of wire is mu naught I by 4 pi d into 1 plus sin pi. 1 plus sin pi. This is case 3. Next, we will discuss case 4. So, after that, you will get a clear idea about all the cases of Biot-Savart's law. First application. Next, I will discuss case 4. Case 4. So here, the point lies. Point lies one of the end of finite length of wire. The point lies one of the end of finite length of wire. So this is a finite length of wire. For this finite length of wire, here is the point. Okay, point lies on here. Point lies on here. This is a finite length of wire. That means for finite length, ends are fixed. So this end is fixed. This end is fixed. Okay. So what is the first step? Draw an imaginary line from the point to this. Okay, imaginary line we draw. Next, so what is the second step? Draw a perpendicular line. So perpendicular line. This is what? D. Perpendicular distance D. And locate angles. What is the third step? Locate angles. This is an angle. So this is some pi 1. Okay. And what is pi 2? Pi 2 is equal to here 0 degrees. Because this fixed end and this point P both are coincide here. So, this point lies axis of this fixed end. That's why pi 2 is equal to 0 degrees. Let us consider this is equal to some pi. So, then what we got? Magnetic field at point P is equal to mu naught I by 4 pi d into sin pi 1 plus sin pi 2. This is a general formula. Then mu naught I by 4 pi d into sin pi 1 means sin pi. Sin pi 2 means 0 degrees. So from this, mu naught I by 4 pi d sin pi we got magnetic field at this point P. Okay. If point lies on axis. So now node point. If any point lies on axis of straight wire, if any point lies on axis of straight wire, then magnetic field at that point is, at that point is equal to 0. So this node point is very very important. This node point is very very important. If any point is lies on axis, here two ends are there. With respect to this end, point lies on axis. With respect to this end, point is somewhere. That's why pi 1 is equal to pi, pi 2 is equal to 0. Okay, we consider. So if any point lies on axis of, if any point lies on axis of straight wire, then magnetic field at that point is must equal to 0. For example, I will solve one question based upon this. You will get clear idea. One question I will solve, then you will get a clear idea. You will get clear idea. Question number one. Find magnetic field at a point Q. At point Q, which is lies on axis of current carrying straight wire. Observe carefully here. Find magnetic field at point Q, which is lies on axis of current carrying straight wire. So this is a straight wire I consider. This is a straight wire. Okay. So point lies on. This is an axis. What is this? This is an axis. Point lies on somewhere. Here it is a point I consider. Here is a point. Q is a point. So based upon the question, I draw the diagram here. This is a straight wire. This line is called axis. This is what here? Axis. Okay. The line which is passing through the straight wire is called axis. The line which is coincide with the straight wire is called axis. Okay. So this is axis. Point lies on axis. What is magnetic field at this point Q? Now, point lies on axis means this is two ends are there here. One end is fixed end, and this one end of this end also fixed end. So due to this end, angle is equal to pi 1 is equal to 0 here. Pi 2 is equal to 0. Because this point is coincide with this fixed end. This point is coincide with this fixed end. So that means pi 1 is equal to 0. Pi 2 is equal to 0. Pi 1 is equal to 0. Pi 2 is equal to 0. Then magnetic field at Q is equal to mu naught I by 4 pi d into sine pi 1 plus sine pi 2. Pi 1 plus sine pi 2. Then what we got here? Mu naught I by 4 pi d into sine pi 1 value. Sine pi 1 value 0. Sine pi 2 value also 0 degrees. Sine 0 value 0. Then what we got here? 0. Magnetic field at Q is equal to 0. If any point lies on axis of straight wire, then magnetic field at that point is equal to 0. Here Q is the point lies on axis of the straight wire. That's why magnetic field at that point Q is equal to 0. So this is question number 1. So I hope all of you understood this. Now we will discuss few more numericals based upon this concept. Well, to continuing my lecture on numericals on magnetic field due to long straight current carrying conductor. So here I will consider one numerical. Numericals on applications of Biot-Savart's law. A straight wire carries current 3 amps. Calculate magnitude of magnetic field at a point 10 centimeter away from the wire. So what is given data? Straight wire, that is not a finite length of wire, am I right? Straight wire. So straight wire means here this is infinite length of wire. Given infinite length of wire. Infinite length of wire. Wire length not given in the question means definitely that is considered as infinite length of wire. Dear student, in the question they didn't mention length of the wire, then we should consider that wire is infinite length of wire. This is infinite length of wire. So for infinite length of wire, current passing through this wire is 3 amps. Current passing through this wire is 3 amps. Infinite length of wire means 2 ends are free ends. 2 ends are free ends. So this is a free end. This is a free end. Okay, free end. Okay, calculate magnitude of magnetic field at a point 10 centimeter away from the wire. 10 centimeter away from the wire. So this is a point I consider. This is some point P I consider. This is situated at distance they given. This is a D. D is equal to 10 centimeter. Perpendicular distance. So if one point is lies 10 centimeter from this wire, infinite length of wire, what is magnetic field at this point P? So we need to find magnetic field at this point P. We need to find. How to find this? So magnetic field. Magnetic field due to infinite length of wire. Dear student, please recapitulate the concept of previous lectures. So already I discussed this magnetic field due to infinite length of wire. This is a case 1 in application 1. Case 1 in application 1, applications of Biot-Savart's law. Case 1 in application 1 of Biot-Savart's law. So what is the formula here? Magnetic field due to infinite length of wire formula. B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi d. Mu naught I by 2 pi d. Magnetic field due to infinite length of wire formula. B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi d. So mu naught into I value is what? 3 amps. Here 2 into pi into d value is what? 10 centimeter. 10 centimeters means 10 into 10 power minus 2. So d value is what here? D value is equal to 10 into 10 power minus 2 meters. I convert into meters. So d is 10 into 10 power minus 2. So you know already mu naught by 4 pi means 10 power minus 7. 10 power minus 7. Then mu naught by 2 pi means here we can write 4 pi as 2 into 2 pi. This 2 will be moved this side. Mu naught by 2 pi means 2 into 10 power minus 7. Mu naught by 4 pi means 10 power minus 7. Mu naught by 2 pi means 2 into 10 power minus 7. 2 into 10 power minus 7. So mu naught by 2 pi value is 2 into 10 power minus 7 into 3 by 10 into 10 power minus 2 means 10 power minus 1. 10 power minus 1. So now 2 into 3, 6. 6 into. So 2 into 3, 6. 6 into 10 power minus 7 by 10 power minus 1. A power m by a power n. A power m minus n. Minus 7 plus 1. 10 power minus 6. 6 into 10 power minus 6. What is the unit of magnetic field? SI unit of magnetic field is Tesla. So that is indicated with T. Okay. That means the magnetic field at the point situated 10 centimeter from the wire is 6 into 10 power minus 6 Tesla. So this is answer for this question. Dear student, I will recapitulate one more time. So please observe carefully. So these numericals are very important for the board as well as NEET point of view. Question number 2. A straight wire carries current 3 amps. Calculate magnitude of magnetic field at a point 10 centimeter away from the wire. Okay. So what they given? A straight wire carries current value 3 amps. So current value is the given 3 amps. I value is 3 amps. Next, calculate magnetic field. We need to find magnetic field at a point which is situated distance 10 centimeter from the wire. So draw a wire. They given straight wire. So they didn't mention length in the wire. This is very important point. In the question, they didn't mention length of the wire. Then we should consider as that is infinite length of wire. So this is infinite length of wire. Okay. So current I value is 3 amps. So D value is 10 into 10 power minus 2. We will substitute all values. So we will get, you know, already magnetic field due to infinite length of wire formula. B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi D. B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi D. This is very, very important formula. Magnetic field due to infinite length of wire formula. Mu naught I by 2 pi D. So this is a solution for this question. So next we will discuss one more numerical on based upon this concept. Well, to continuing my lecture on numericals on Biot Savart's law, so observe carefully. Question number 3. What current must flows in a infinite long straight wire? So given. So what we need to find? What current must flows? What is the meaning of that? We need to find electric current I flows infinite long straight wire. What is the wire? Infinite long straight wire. Infinite long straight wire. Okay. So to give a flux density. Dear student, here very, very important point is, first note point is, magnetic field has so many names. Magnetic field, so what are magnetic flux density, or are magnetic induction, or are strength of magnetic field, so they will give in this any word. So magnetic field or magnetic flux density, magnetic induction, strength of magnetic field, all words having same meaning that indicate B only. Okay. So all are having same meaning. Magnetic field or magnetic flux density or magnetic induction or strength of magnetic field. So having same meaning. They given here magnetic flux density. Magnetic flux density is nothing but magnetic field only. How to indicate magnetic field? B. B is equal to, they given 3 into 10 power minus 5 Tesla. Otherwise, you don't know this term, just observe unit. What is this unit? This is Tesla. Am I right? Now, Tesla is the unit of, you know already, Tesla is a unit of magnetic field. Okay, so magnetic flux density is also called as magnetic field. So, magnetic flux density, so B is equal to 3 into 10 power minus 5 Tesla, they given. And at 6 centimeters, D value is given, perpendicular distance, D value is given 6 centimeters. We can write 6 into 10 power minus 2 meters. So from the wire, what we need to find? I value. So you know already, magnetic field due to current carrying infinite length of wire. So B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi D. B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi D. So here, I want here I value. I is equal to. So here, I is equal to. First substitute values. What is the given values? 3 into 10 power minus 5. mu naught by 2 pi. You know already, we know already mu naught by 4 pi value is 10 power minus 7. Then mu naught by 2 pi value is 2 into 10 power minus 7. So that, well, magnetic field 3 into 10 power minus 5 here. The given already magnetic field value. Mu naught by 2 pi means 2 into 10 power minus 7. And here mu naught by 2 pi we got. And into I is equal to into I by D. D means 6 into 10 power minus 2. 6 into 10 power minus 2. So we need to find I value. We need to find here I value. So here 2 how many times? 3 times. 10 power minus 2 how many times it will be? Nearly 10 power minus 5 times. So what is left finally here? What value is left here? So we will get current value is, we'll get current I is equal to, electric current I is equal to, this 3 will be moved this side, 3 into 10 power minus 5. And this 10 power minus 5 is there now here, that is in denominator, we should move 10 power minus 5. Here 10 power minus 5, 10 power minus 5 going to be cancelled. So electric current I is equal to, we got 9 amps. So what is electric current here? 9 amps. So here, this is the solution of this question. Electric current I is equal to 9 amps. So simple thing, if you know the formula, magnetic field due to current carrying infinite length of wire. So if you apply that formula, we'll get answer easily. So B is equal to, what is the formula of magnetic field due to infinite length of wire? B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi d. Mu naught I by 2 pi d. Okay, so this is the solution of this question. Next, we will discuss one more numerical based upon this concept. Well, to continuing my lecture on numericals on Biot Savart's law, observe carefully. Question number 4. Magnetic induction at a point P, which is at a distance of 4 cm from a long current carrying wire, is 10 power minus 3 Tesla. That means, given magnetic field at a point P is equal to, magnetic field at a point P is equal to 10 power minus 3 Tesla. Okay, distance is 4 centimeters. So let us consider that is a sum D1. D1 is equal to 4 centimeters. That is nothing but, we can write that this is a 4 centimeter they given. We can write as 4 into 10 power minus 2 meters. Next, what is the magnetic induction? You know already, magnetic flux density, magnetic induction, magnetic field, strength of magnetic field, these are all names are same. These are all having same meaning. Magnetic field is also called as magnetic flux density. Magnetic field is also called as magnetic induction. So what we need to find here? What is the magnetic induction? That means we need to find magnetic induction at a point Q. So we need to find magnetic induction at a point Q. Okay, question mark. What is the distance of 12 centimeter? That means D2 value they given. D2 is equal to 12 centimeter. Nothing but 12 into 10 power minus 2 meters. Okay. So from the current carrying wire. They given here, long current carrying wire. Long current carrying wire means here, so magnetic field due to current carrying wire, long straight current carrying wire, long current carrying wire, current carrying wire. So long current carrying wire is nothing but infinite wire, am I right? That is the meaning of, that is infinite wire, am I right? Infinite wire. So infinite length of wire. You know already, magnetic field due to infinite length of wire formula. B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi d. Mu naught I by 2 pi d. here electric current value is doesn't given, I value constant does not given means we just neglect mu naught by 2 pi, mu naught value constant, 2 pi value constant, b is inversely proportional to d. That means if distance is decreases, magnetic field is increases. If distance from the wire is decreases, magnetic field is increases. If distance is increases, magnetic field is decreases. Inversely proportional relation. B is inversely proportional to D. So B is inversely proportional to D. So based upon this relation, we will solve this question. B is inversely proportional to D. So observe carefully. B is inversely proportional to D. So now, from this, B is inversely... Well, so observe carefully here. Magnetic field at point P is equal to 10 power minus 3 Tesla. Distance from point P to long straight wire is 4 centimeter. That is a centimeter convert into meters. 4 into 10 power minus 2 meters. Next, magnetic field at a point Q we need to find. And D2 is nothing but, so distance from point Q to long straight wire. So that is 12 centimeter, 12 into 10 power minus 2 meters. If you convert into meters, we will get 12 into 10 power minus 2 meters. You know already, magnetic field due to a long straight wire, B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi d. So from this, magnetic field is inversely proportional to D. Magnetic field is inversely proportional to D. So now substitute BP by BQ is equal to D2 by D1. So here BP means 10 power minus 3 Tesla. And BQ means, because it is inversely proportional relation, at BP distance is D1. At BQ distance is D2. That's why BP by BQ is equal to D2 by D1. So 10 power minus 3 by BQ. BQ is equal to D2 value is 12 into 10 power minus 2 by D1 is 4 into 10 power minus 2. So this how many times? 3 times. 4, 3 times 10 power minus 2, 10 power minus 2 cancel. So BQ is equal to 1 by 3 into 10 power minus 3 Tesla. So we can write 1 by 3 is nothing but 0.33 into 10 power minus 3 Tesla. So 0.33 into 10 power minus 3 Tesla. So this is this value we'll get here. So for how many times? 3 times. So this is magnetic field at point Q. 0.33 into 10 power minus 3 Tesla. So this is the answer for this question. So in next lectures, we'll discuss few more details about this chapter, magnetic effect of current. So I hope all of you understood this. So we'll discuss few more concepts based upon this chapter in further lectures. So please revise the concepts regularly and practice numericals. So all the very best.